the fourth day in a row it's rising.
Yeah, okay. Well, let's talk about some of the big gainers actually. Eicher Motors is one stock that should come up for you. This year, Eicher Motors has gained about 30-odd%, and it's up 20% from the lows that we saw in the month of January. Commercial vehicle sales have improved on a sequential basis if you look at it. You know, in February, we did see an improvement compared to what we saw in Jan. So the total volumes were down 7% year on year, but compared to 5,900 units sold in Jan, they moved to 6,400 in Feb. Vinod Aggarwal, the MD and CEO of the Volvo Eicher commercial vehicle business, joins us now. Mr. Aggarwal, good morning. Is the worst over in terms of a slowdown in the commercial vehicle space, and will the volumes improve further from here?
If you look at every year, Jan to March quarter is a better quarter. Relatively, it's a better quarter. So from that point of view, you will see better sales in March. Even though it may still be less than the last year, Jan to March, but still the March sales will be, per se, if you look at the numbers, I think they are expected to be better. Even Jan Feb also, even though when you compare with respect to previous year's quarter, there was a drop. But overall, I would say the numbers are still good. And hopefully next year also, I think after the elections, the industry should do better.
Mr. Aggarwal, good morning. Thanks for joining. Can you give us some color of how this quarter is looking? I mean, are there any NBFC problems which were there last quarter but not so severe this quarter? Is there any difference being made from the rural transfers by the various state governments, you know, the farm income, and by the central government? Just describe the quarter for us, please.
No, if you look at the quarter, first is the NBFCs. NBFCs, I think they are more and more coming out of the problem now, and there are only, I think, one or two companies which are left out. Otherwise, everything is back to normal. However, the rates of interest are still high. And then if you look at earlier, if they were financing more percentage of a vehicle, if loan-to-vehicle ratio was earlier almost 95% or 100%, now it has come down to say 80%, 85% or 90%. So there is, you know, percentage financing is slightly come down, and the rates of interest have gone up. So this is, I think, the structural change which has happened, and this might continue going forward, because all these financial companies or the banks, they are more careful. So they are more careful about the NPAs. So from that point of view, I think this industry will have to adjust to that the LTVs or loan to vehicle ratio will continue to be lower than whatever it was earlier. And then of course the second is rural economy. Of course it is expected to be better only because there is more money going to come in the hands of rural people, and then we are expecting good monsoon again next year, and overall rural economy will be all right. But the biggest driver of the CV industry is the infrastructure. Even this year, we have seen 50% growth in the tippers. YTD February, there is a 50% growth. Then the other biggest driver, if you look at the segment-wise industry, 12 to 15-ton industry, which is driven by e-commerce or new-age logistics companies. For example, the parcel movement, or for example, the movement by the component companies. Or if you look at some of the other perishable items. So the 12 to 15 ton growth is 40% YTD February. Construction trucks growth is 50%. However, if you look at some of the haulage segments, like multi-axis segment or the tractors, which were growing very fast around 4 months back, those have little bit dropped because of the lag effect of axle load norms, because there has been some adjustments in the capacities of fleet operators. So due to that, there is some lower demand, and that is also because of some low replacements which have happened in last few months. However, the replacement cycle again will gain momentum maybe after 3-4 months.
Okay. Mr. Aggarwal, you know, post quarter three in the conference call, you guys mentioned that the key reason for the fall in the commercial vehicle margins was heavy discounting, especially in the heavy duty segment. Is discounting still very high, and should we expect your margins to drop further below the 6.5% level?
Discounting still is continuing, because that's the situation which is there currently. and it is continuing. It has not come down. We have not seen any improvement. However, as far as we are concerned, we are very clear that we will not discount our products beyond a point. We have fixed our limits that we will not go beyond a point. So that is why you would have seen there has been some, our market share are a little bit down in the light and medium duty trucks, 5 to 15 ton, we are down to 30% market share. That is clearly because we are putting our foot down on the discounts beyond a point. Similarly, on the heavy duty trucks also, we are still at 5% market share because of the discounting, we are not going beyond a point. So we are not running after the market shares, and we are very clear that at what price we will sell.
So have we seen the worst in terms of a margin fall because of this discounting issue? And what kind of ballpark margins would you work with for the rest of the year?
No, our EBITDA margins, if you look at YTD December 1st 9 months, our EBITDA margins were around 9%. Which is a good margin, and it may go up a little bit because of the volume leverage. If we get the higher volumes, there may be some improvement in the margins. However, 9% is a fairly good margin, 9% or around that margin. It's a good margin.
Okay. Any numbers you can share on market share in the various products?
As I mentioned, in the light and medium duty, we are at 30%, and in heavy duty, we are at 5%, and in buses, we are at 16%, and then in exports, we are doing very well. We have, till last month, we have already exported close to 9,000 trucks and buses, which is almost equal to last year's. So after March exports, we will have good growth in exports also, and we have added new markets in exports. We have started exporting to Indonesia, to South Africa. We are exporting more to Middle East. Apart from our strong markets in the South Asia, like Bangladesh, Nepal, or Sri Lanka. So exports hold good potential for us. And then, of course, the heavy duty, as it is, continues to be a good potential area for growth, because we are only at 5% market share. And I'm sure with our range of products and with all the modernization that we have introduced, and when BS6 comes, I think relatively we will be in a more advantageous position, because we are already exporting Euro 6 engines to Volvo Group. So I think as the market moves up more and more, if as and when it is modernizing more and more, I think we will get better and better advantage.
Mr. Aggarwal, can you just gaze a bit into the April, May, June quarter? How do elections normally impact you all? Is there more demand simply because, people are spending more in the rural areas to move around? Again, we are seeing these farm transfers. What are your dealers telling you? Are they asking for more for the next quarter?
There will be more activity because there will be more expenditures. At the same time, the business people, they also don't take calls on the more investments, because they will take their calls after the government is in place, anticipating that what is going to happen when the new government comes in. So you will see, some of the holdups by the big fleet operators, they may not go in for big replacements. That will happen after the government comes in. But because of the more spending in the marketplace, because of the election money which is getting spent, there will be more activity and there will be more money in the hands of various people, and that which they will spend that money on the various FMCG items or on the consumption items. So you will see better consumption, and it will be more consumption-led increase in demand. However, at the same time, the replacement cycle that has to happen, that will happen more after the government is in place.
Okay, so one final question then. Year to date, if you look at it, the commercial vehicle volumes have gone up about 13%. What is the outlook for FY20? Can we still eke out a double-digit growth for the sector and the company?
For the sector, I am very optimistic, because 19-20 is a very big changeover year, because from 1/4/2020 you will see movement to BS6, and BS6 would mean increase in prices, and also it will be a new emission norms vehicle, and there will be lot of changes in the aftermarket requirements. So due to that, the customers would prefer that if they have to buy, say, example in 2021, they would try to prepone. Like if someone has to buy in first 6 months of 2021, he would try to see that can he buy in 1920 itself. So you will see some impact of pre-buying. and that will going to impact the demand in 1920. So 1920, we are expecting that there will be rebuying impact. Because of that, the market may grow still based on the higher volumes of 18-19. Because 18-19, you will touch new peaks in all the industry segments. Like, for example, heavy-duty trucks, it will be a new peak close to 300,000. Light and medium duty, it will again be new peak close to 115,000. And buses also, it will be very good number. And exports are well. So this 18-19, first of all, I think the overall market, including exports, commercial vehicle, including smaller trucks, it will be more than 1 million. So okay. Last year it was 900,000. So you will see a growth of 10-12%. And on top of it, you will see more growth in next year because of pre-buying.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, Mr. Aggarwal, for the wealth of details and perspective that you have brought to the commercial vehicle sector and your own performance. Thank you very much for joining us. Well, in the meanwhile, the markets are far.